Joining me now is the CEO of SandboxAQ, Jack Hidary, is with us. SandboxAQ was spun out of Google parent company Alphabet 3 years ago. Its large quantitative models deliver critical advances in life sciences, financial services, navigation, cyber, and other sectors. Jack assesses the state of the AI race right now. Jack, great to have you.
Maria, great to be here.
Thank
How you doing?
Thank you so much
it
for being
It is wild
here.
Times in AI.
It really is. And the name of your company, SandboxAQ.
A for AI, Q for quantum. Bringing it all together.
Playing in the sandbox together. You're the only one who's doing that.
That's right.
Do you need quantum and AI together as a company? You're B2B.
Yeah, we're all B2B, right? We're here for biopharma. We're here to make the new medicines for Alzheimer's, for dementia, for cancer. These are diseases that we need to address. We're here to make new chemicals for industry, to lightweight vehicles, to address also financial analysis. When we think about the financial projections of the future in terms of portfolio optimization, you need AI and quantum coming together, AQ.
Why?
Because these are higher dimensional areas. So when you think about, for example, a new pharma product, a new medicine, we don't need an AI that's as good as humans. We need an AI that's better than humans. Humans, Maria, have not done very well making medicine. We have pancreatic cancer, still no cure. Brain cancer, still no cure. Alzheimer's, still no cure. Humans are actually not very good at this stuff. We need an AI that takes us to the next step beyond what we can do today.
That's incredible. I mean, you're right that all of those diseases have no cure, but how's AI going to cure it and quantum?
So what we have to do is we have to go beyond large language models. Right now, the shiny object of the day for the past 2 years, Maria, has been large language models, ChatGPT, now DeepSeek, things like that. Very useful for cost cutting when you want to cut costs in a big company, like with customer service. But you want to think about a new molecule, the new chemical, we don't want to use a model trained on Reddit and cat pictures, right? We want a model trained on chemistry, on pharmacology, on the biology of these diseases. That's LQM, large quantitative models, LQM versus LLM. This is the area that SandboxAQ is the global pace setter.
This is very interesting what you're saying.
Yeah, so it's a whole new era of AI, Maria, that it really has not been focused on
as
much.
No, it hasn't. Yeah. And I want to know how you're expecting timing to play out. I mean, what would be your timing in terms of a cure for Alzheimer's now that you've got AI and quantum working together?
Well, right now already we're working with UCSF, University of California, San Francisco. Stan Prusner won the Nobel Prize there for his work on neurodegen diseases. Those are diseases that affect everyone's family, Maria, in America, right? We think about Alzheimer's, dementia, Parkinson's, ALS. Every family, unfortunately, is or will be affected by these diseases.
Has been touched by one of those, yeah.
And we're already cutting down the time and cost needed to get into clinical trial, and succeeding better in those clinical trials. We need to change those numbers. The numbers today are not good. 90% failure today in clinical trial before we apply this new kind of AI.
Wow.
We're hoping to really impact this.
I love what you're saying. Now, SandboxAQ raised more than, $300 million at a valuation higher than $5.6 billion.
That's right. That's the most recent round. Total $800 million plus raised for over two rounds.
So how do you allocate that money? How do you plan on using that money?
Yeah. So that money really goes to two key areas. First of all, is product development itself. We're a software company. We build software and then companies license that software. So Sanofi, for example, is a large pharma company. They license our software to develop drugs faster and better. We also have different companies in the chemical space, like Dow Chemical and others, using our software as well. We just announced Aramco 2 weeks ago in the hydrocarbon space, taking the output of hydrocarbon companies and upvaluing it so they can make more money, but also lower their footprint in the market as well. So we are a software company. Number one use of proceeds, Maria, for our raises is focus on product development, the engineers and the coders. Number two is go to market. We announced go to market with Accenture, with Google Cloud, with Deloitte, and those are our go to market partners to scale this company.
You know, I love the idea that your ultimate goal, and one of the goals, is to address these healthcare issues with AI. Do you see more hospitals using AI as a result of this and this need for progress there? We spoke with Sarah Fryer, and she was talking about consumers and businesses, but I want to know specifically within healthcare, how is this being deployed?
Yeah, well, right now at Mount Sinai, right here in New York City, just about 10 blocks away, one of our AIs is in trial right there to look at heart disease. Heart disease is the number one killer in America today, cardiac disease. And we have a trial going on at Mount Sinai Hospital here in New York City and at Mayo Clinic in Rochester, Minnesota, to use an advanced quantitative AI to look at the signals coming out of your heart. And we need to do better. When people show up with chest pain at a trauma center, at an emergency room, unfortunately, they're not getting immediate care because it takes too long to figure out what exactly is the problem they have with that chest pain. 8 million chest pain presentations to emergency rooms in America every year. 8 million.
Amazing.
Only a small portion of those need immediate heart attack type of treatment, but it's hard to differentiate. It takes hours at most emergency rooms. The AI that we developed at SandboxAQ is in trial right now at Mount Sinai and Mayo Clinic to address this specific issue. So we do think that AI is going to be a critical component in the hospital setting as well.
And you keep adapting. I mean, you're a serial entrepreneur, Jack. We go back.
I love innovation.
Years.
We go back many years.
Many years, yeah. And I've watched you deal with and create new ideas in different companies. Tell us about the opportunities and the policies that you need to see coming out of this new White House to address those opportunities.
Well, what we want to see is really strong support for AI, but all forms of AI. So we have strong support already for language models. That's great. Language models have a lot of great applications in terms of reducing costs for business, for customer service. Obviously, college kids are loving language models, writing their essays with language models. But we also want to see support for quantitative AI. AI that's not only good for businesses, but also for the Defense Department, for national security. Let's talk about cybersecurity. Right now, there may not be a war with America in terms of kinetic war, bombs going off, but there's a war every day, every minute, every second, Maria, in the cyberspace.
I know.
Every day, yeah. The Pentagon gets hit. Every day, the other agencies get hit with cyber attacks from China specifically, from Iran, and from other nation state and other non-nation state actors like North Korea. We have to defend better against these cyber attacks. And AI forms a key role, not only for the hackers, because they use AI, but also in the defense of our country as well.
Well, it's very important, and national security is of high importance for our audience and certainly on my agenda as well. But do you think that if we're using those tools here in America, the adversary can use the same tools?
They are using these tools right now.
Yeah.
So when we look at the capabilities, the offensive cyber capabilities in Iran, in China specifically, very much embracing of AI. China, of course, is taking a big role in the advancement of AI right now. We look at both dragons and tigers when we analyze the AI landscape in China. I know DeepSeek has taken a lot of the headlines, but actually, if you look at the top of the post right now, it's Alibaba's Qwen, Q-W-E-N, short for Qianwen, which means 1,000 questions. That is their language model right now in China out of Alibaba. And we put them in the dragons category because one of the big companies, Alibaba, Baidu, ByteDance, each have very strong AIs that are out there. Then, of course, you have the tigers coming up, and I think we might have a graphic on this, nipping at the heels of the dragons in terms of DeepSeek and Shipu and other types of up-and-coming Chinese companies. Also, Kai-Fu Lee's O1.ai is another one of these tigers coming up right now in China. So China's a very, very broad landscape of AI companies right now.
Do you see your B2B customers upping their IT spending on this? Do B2B, mid-cap, small-cap, large-cap companies understand the threat, and are they increasing their budgets?
We're starting to see that just last year, Maria. I think the initial focus of AI was kind of check the box.
Yes.
Are we using AI? Every C-suite,
right.
Up and down 6th Avenue, here and around the world was like, are we using AI? Are we using large language models? And they went through that exercise. That was called checklist AI. Now we're getting down to the rubber meets the road AI impact. So if you're General Motors, for example, and you have the opportunity to use AI to reduce your customer service costs, of course you're going to do that. That's table stakes.
Yeah.
But the thing that GM actually makes is cars. And to make a car, we have to talk about materials. And to make materials, we have to talk about AI that's trained on chemistry and physics and engineering. That is LQM. That's the AI that we do. Mm. And so I think 2025, 2026, Maria, are going to be the years that we start to see the impact of LQM versus just LLM. The two are complementary.
Yeah, I love it. I love this idea that quantum and AI live together in the Sandbox AQ.
That's right.
Jack, great to have you this
morning.
Great
to see you, Maria.
Thanks so much. Jack Hidary here. Stay with us. We'll be right back.